Those guys are cool. They seem to be having a blast.
Yeah. So you didn't watch SpongeBob or
Whenever I was at friends' houses, I would. But
I really like SpongeBob. You know, I really do. I want to say something now. Mm-hmm. Mike's girlfriend, Lana, she likes fish, and she had a betta fish that she had for a very long time, like a month, 2 months. She became very connected to this fish, and Mike was telling me that she dressed her aquarium for the fish with little SpongeBob trinkets.
Yeah.
Squidward's house, mm-hmm. SpongeBob house, the Krusty Krab.
Krusty Krab.
And then
Just take a big rock out of Logan's yard and put it in there as well, and then voila, then she's got Patrick's house.
To say it, but the fish died.
A lot of them died. Well, that is a big kill off.
Yeah.
And we found out there's like a list of 18 reasons why your fish may have died.
Yep.
And number 17 is they don't like the decorations.
Yeah. Poor decor choice. They're,
all right, yeah.
So where I'm going with this is, essentially the fish didn't like SpongeBob. So my mm-hmm. question was, did the fish deserve to die?
do you think they had a choice? Do you think they're like, ugh, it's SpongeBob, gross?
That's what I'm saying. Like, I don't know like the specific television interests that
fish have. They always seem like more of like Rugrats or like Rocko's mm-hmm. Modern.
Just so by the way, the Krusty Krab, I'm pretty sure that they're eating other crabs because the Krusty Krab is actually a crab trap. Get it?
Mm-hmm. Life, fish.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you didn't watch more animation. Like cartoons and
no comics? Family Guy or any of that shit.
No, that was not allowed in my
wait,
family.
Wait, what about
I
now?
I just saw a part of this video. I think where like there's a Family Guy.
They have Peter from Family Guy.
That's just like a little meme. No, you were thinking of the Family Guy face that was in the Mr. Beast video.
Yes.
No, that's just like a little meme. Okay. I always put in little Easter eggs in my videos because
I can imagine. I was gonna ask about those.
Oh yeah,
I imagine there's plenty, tons.
Like all those people who worked on the video. That's yep. technically an Easter egg, yep. I guess. Because animation, you have to draw everything, right? Yep. And so if there's like a board with like a bunch of paper on it, and you have to, you know, to for like the newest video, it's about crazy people. So there's a lot of like boards with red strings and newspaper clippings and stuff. And so I'm drawing that, and I just put in all these little Easter eggs because you know it's you're really not going to see it unless you pause.
I hope I'm not in it. Not. You said crazy people. I was like, fuck.
No.
Mike's mom thinks I'm weird.
Oh, I mean, I've only just met you today.
I think we're all weird.
I'm weird.
It's true. So the crazy people that I was talking about. So when I'm drawing on YouTube, when I'm like making videos, I'm sitting at my desk just, I instead of listening to podcasts or music or audiobooks, I'll find these channels that just talk about really crazy stuff, like being abducted by aliens. They talk about why the government is all lizard people.
Can you call it surrealism? Or?
It's a little. What are you up to?
Yeah, he does that. He does it every single episode.
I want
actually.
Someone who watches Impulsive to track the exact moment in each episode where I turn my chair around.
Happens every single
bet
episode.
It's like 9 minutes and 30.
If I do that, can I get a spot on Impulsive? And I'll mark it every single time.
It's like it's on the dot, each one. But so you watch people who got abducted by aliens.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You got abducted by aliens.
Well, I didn't. I just watched people who
Is that
did.
A goal of yours?
If I get abducted by aliens, then I'll be like, shoot, I'm one of the crazy people. That's what I'd say.
What if you actually get abducted by aliens?
I don't know. I would... There would be a lot of things that I would think it was before I would think, oh, I got abducted. I would think, oh, I'm getting pranked by my friend Logan Paul if I got abducted by aliens.
Who spent billions of dollars on this spacecraft.
Yeah. Or having a prostate exam. Because the first thing they do, every single alien, is
they probe,
anal
probe. You. They
it's
probe
guaranteed 100%. It's
But if I kept going like, is this Logan? And the aliens just were like, meet Morp. And I was like, oh, man, that's... This is really intense.
Yeah.
Just like the more I think about it, then it's aliens. Then I guess I'd want to be abducted by aliens.
Look, we all get our inspiration from different places. I like that you're listening to these off breed channels.
Mm-hmm.
So what other kind of like weird things are you And by the way, where do you find this stuff? Do you get caught in like the YouTube hole?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Rabbit hole.
There's like a handful of channels that I just go back to every so often. Just, how are they doing? And I just... It's really good background noise, because a lot of times it's just them in their room talking about their experience, and you know, I'm not looking at their screens, just a little weird version of ASMR for me, and I'm just drawing my little character, and they're like, oh, so the green aliens, they're not as nice as the Pleiadians.
No
it
way.
Just, and it just hits your brain, yeah. And makes
and
you...
And it just, for some reason, just the thought, like, wow, these people exist, and we're both...
I believe aliens exist. I don't believe that they visit us. Because I'm thinking with the literal trash ball in the universe, the alien, the teen aliens might drive past and throw their beer cans in, and that's what meteors are, and they'll just zoom past.
Humans and just their worldview is so different than mine. Like, it's fascinating.
It is, mm-hmm. But does it make you paranoid?
Do I...
Like, are you a conspiracy theorist?
No, I'm not really.
You just are fascinated by conspiracy theorists and...
Pretty much,
believers.
Yeah.
So am I.
So do you think the Earth is flat?
The Earth is flat. The Earth is flat.
Is this a loaded question?
No, I just want to know. Like, what's your
I don't think the Earth is flat. But I know that you kind of have experience with that, Logan. So actually, I watched your documentary.
Oh, you
it.
Did?
Yeah.
Oh, great. So you know I don't think the Earth is
flat.
Yeah.
I know it's
absolute morons.
I remember in the video, like in the bottom right corner, I was like, "That's just a joke."
Okay, great. All right,
great. Yeah, I don't know. It was, I thought it was an entertaining
little
fake documentary.
Thanks, bro. Yeah, we.
That was a fun one.
Did you hear about the Mad Mike Hughes? He was the one guy in our video. He crashed his homemade rocket perished recently. So
oh no, that's not good.
Once again, rest in peace, Mad Mike Hughes.
Are you an introvert?
Oh, like all animators are introverts.
Yeah.
It takes a very specific kind of person to want to sit at home and draw for 8 hours a day. You know, mm-hmm. I don't know. In class, was there ever any kid that was the art kid?
Pixel.
Yeah, and of course, in every grade of school, there was the art kid, and I think he would always get made fun of by people, and then I didn't realize till after that he was actually probably the coolest kid in the fucking class, mm-hmm. but no one realized it, and now he's making millions of dollars making little white fluffy people on YouTube.
Yeah, we're all friends now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you guys got like a little squad. Like, you guys got like a little squad, and you also like own Reddit. Like, you guys just all band together. Like, yo, we could bury you right now. Your small business will perish as a result of our art band. Like, we could downvote you into non-existence.
How did you manage to translate your following so well across social media?
Oh boy!
Being like, this is your Instagram. You have 2.3 million followers, and you're getting 10 to 12% engagement, which is amazing, which is incredible for
hold on
across social media.
Oh boy!
Be like, this is your Instagram. You have two.
Logan's got 19 likes, 19 new followers, and 2 mentions. There's no little thingy, so you can't see how many DMs he just got. Also, let's see here. CNB, Facebook, Social Blaze, Social Blaze for Instagram, YouTube, Gmail, Google Drive, Genesis, Internet Speed, Streamlab, Moobot, Shopify, Logan Paul, something official, and Live Social Counter, and Nest. And there's obviously like a shit ton more. He's got Fighting in Mr. Beast's 1K, The Odd Ones YouTube, The Odd Ones Out Instagram, Odd Ones New, I think they mean net worth looks like it's 5 something. Life is Fun by featuring Doivin Boy in a Bed, Junk Food. So we know what we're getting.
3 million followers, and you're getting 10 to 12% engagement, which is amazing, which is incredible for a creator.
Thank you.
And I guess I just want to know, because I'm fascinated being a personality and like a face. I'm fascinated how you can go from this character to a very successful multi-platform business.
So what are you asking for specifically?
How'd you do it? Do you plug your Instagram?
Oh, yeah.
Your engagement's amazing.
I guess I always just plug it at the end of videos. It's funny that you're bringing up Instagram, because I'm a lot more active on Twitter. But
I love
Twitter like,
so much.
I have like half as many followers on Twitter than
Mike
Instagram.
Likes Twitter.
If you're asking like, oh, how do you do Instagram? I have no idea, because I just post pictures of my dog on my Instagram.
Really?
Twitter's the shit, dude.
This is
Jack might get replaced. Jack Dorsey.
In discussion?
Jack might get
Jack Dorsey.
He'd be stepping down, right? Or
no, he's getting replaced.
He's getting outed. Ousted. I mean, he's very liberal, yeah.
Is he getting canceled?
Jack got canceled? Mm-hmm. What'd he do?
But Twitter, I just post, like, dumb jokes. Like, I didn't like my hair at first, but now it's growing
on me.
I got one for you. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
I got a couple for you.
Okay, hit me.
You have a seatbelt? Put that shit on. A fire truck is actually a water truck.
Think about it.
Nice. Cigarette companies kill their best customers.
Mm-hmm.
Condom companies kill their future customers. This is my favorite one. If you take the filter out of a vacuum and you give it a good scrub, you become the vacuum cleaner.
Have you ever heard of shower thoughts? Oh.
Okay, so there's one that I know. Cancer research is them just putting themselves out of a job.
That's it, sorry. Nice. Also, every time I made eye contact with that camera, I can't help but notice how fucking lopsided this wide angle is.
It makes
me... Andre, can you shoot? This thing is like this.
I'm uphill, right, for the viewers. I'm uphill. Also, another question. Why is Andre so far back on this one? Doesn't it feel like he's just buried in the back there?
Yeah, he's usually a lot closer in these things.
Yeah. Yo, you've mastered the 1-2 line tweet. Yeah. It is so powerful, and it is the biggest engagement driver. The queen of it, I hate to say it, Alyssa Violet. Violet.
She's so good
at it. 1-2 line tweet, dude, and they blow up. Every one of them's got 50, 60,000 likes on it. She's good at it.
In the space at all, if I were to fling out some names, like, would you know them?
Give me an example. Oh, I guess vloggers? Do you ask if I watch vlogging? Because no, I don't.
I
know of David Dobrik.
Yeah.
Haven't really seen his stuff.
That's
I'm sure he's a nice person. He's very popular at VidCon. So that's
okay. So you're not really consuming that much, which I think is
you
great.
Watch Peace.
Is that a video game person?
No, Mr. Beast.
Oh, Mr. Beast. Yeah, I thought you said Peace.
No, sorry.
Yeah, no, of course I watch Mr. Beast. Yeah, Jimmy's nice.
So you watch all his stuff. So you like all of it. Okay.
Are you doing how are you making the majority of your money? Is it AdSense?
Pretty much. Yeah, that and merch sales. We have a bunch of stuff in retail as of recently.
No way.
Yeah.
No way.
Do you want to go to GameStop or Target? Yeah, it's
no fucking way.
Yeah.
Is it a plush toy?
Yeah, do you see that picture?
That makes sense. I really probably could have just looked at the screen.
How's it selling?
Dude.
And also good. What's that profit look like? You don't have to give an exact number.
The retail stores always do better than like online stuff because it's just a lot more convenient and people are like, oh, they're like in Target and they just see your stuff so they just put in their cart.
I guess I just mean like how much do you actually get off of it?
Like percentage wise?
Yeah. You don't have to give an exact number. I'm just curious.
I don't know the exact. Because I'm a very bad business person. I just want to draw.
Join the club, bro.
Yeah.
The worst.
No. I have like a manager person. Okay. His name's Paul.
Hey, Paul.
Shout out to Paul. Not...
I know your struggles, Paul.
And
I love this.
I should have brought some.
You should have.
That is dope.
Because I want one. I was going to ask about the university.
How close is GameStop from here?
Can we get a reset button? Get that USB stick you have to stick into his back universal, when he shorts out.
Universality?
Help.
Bestiality.
No,
universality. Yeah, it's pretty bestiality. I don't know if you've seen pictures of my dog, but
it's a good-looking dog. I was going to say the universal nature of this of your character.
Mm-hmm.
I think because even if I don't know you, dude, and know your channel, I could be walking through GameStop and be like, "Oh, this is cool."
Thanks.
Did you take any inspiration from Hello Kitty?
No. I
asked for a reason.
there was one person I kind of took a little bit of inspiration from more than others.
Alyssa.
there is this old comic person called Loading Artist.
Okay.
His character design is like white skin. He has like little stick arms, and so I just turned his little sticker arms.
Oh, this guy.
Yeah. So you've probably seen some of his stuff.
Oh, for sure. For sure. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, so like I said, I started out with comics, and there were a lot of web comics that I would read. And I would want to do basically, and so it was interesting because I was spending a lot of time making the comics with like the people and the characters, but like no one was reading them, and I kind of got demotivated. So I just was like, no one cares about these characters. I'm just gonna take multiple steps back and just make a very simplistic character design, just like a white bubble person, no name. It's just gonna be like a human.
I have two questions. All right, two tangents.
Okay,
that
spiked my brain. One, so it looks like your character, you took this character, put like a bike pump in him, and just like made him fluffy.
Yeah, a little bit.
Like, what's that suit? Big Hero 6.
Yeah. Him up.
So the reason I asked about Hello Kitty is because I believe this is true. Fact check me.
Oh shit.
Do you know why Hello Kitty is so popular? Which by the way, I think is top three toys in the world globally.
Is it because it's so recognizable, or
but why?
It's simple.
Close.
It's a cat.
It got no nose.
can't get coronavirus.
It got no nose.
Got
nice.
No nose.
So can't get coronavirus.
Nice. Smart.
Other characters don't have. What's the top two most sold toys?
Let's find out. How would I say this? Top two most.
Top two.
Top two most sold toys. Mm-hmm.
Basically,
ever.
The way you said it.
Top 15 best-selling toys in history. Cause do you have a goal? Are you trying to like?
Spinner? Oh, Mr. Potato
of
Head.
Of course.
I had a Mr. Potato Head. Barbie.
Makes sense.
This is yo-yo. No, we're in no.
Easy Bake Oven.
This ain't right.
Yeah, but who didn't have one of these growing up?
I did
Radio
not have
flower?
One of those.
This ain't right. We're this is wrong.
All right, let me look at what is Hello Kitty so popular.
I didn't know Hello Kitty didn't have a nose. If you asked me to draw Hello Kitty, I probably would have put a nose.
Sorry,
on it.
Yeah. Wait, you said it's because she doesn't have a nose?
Sorry, mouth.
Oh, mouth.
God, cancel this fucking kid.
It's still, still basically because she can't get coronavirus. Also, she can't talk shit.
She's always positive.
She got no mouth.
She's always positive.
Yeah, she's got no mouth. No expression.
Exactly. So
shout out Maggie.
All right, my second question that actually probably you could provide value.
she's got a nose.
Podcast. that you said you were getting demotivated. Because
yeah, a while ago.
Yeah, because your work wasn't getting. Mm-hmm.
Oh, that was like back when I was first starting. Yeah.
Okay, so I also feel like that's a common moment for creators where it's like, yo, I've been working really hard. Mm-hmm. I think my stuff is good, but it's not catching. No tug on the line.
Mm-hmm.
You had a reset phase where you reevaluated everything. How important is that moment, even though you may have put your life and soul into that first bout, that first attempt to try to make it?
How important is the reset?
Yeah.
I would say super important. I think it's, you know, it's always good to self-reflect, like what you said. It's a weird position because I always tell people that, like, don't make content because you want to be the next big
thing.
Sure. You want to make content because you like making content. I don't know how I got this pen. It just appeared in my hand.
That's amazing.
How did he do it?
Yeah, no, I think it was... Anyway, so I always tell people, like, make content because you enjoy making it. And I think for me, when I did that reset, I think I started making content more for myself, I guess. More just to...
Yep.
For the fun of it.
Yep.
You know?
Yep. Your platforms became almost like a resume of your work that you were proud of, which is like, I always try to, for any creator listening to this, I always put that in the back of my head that I'm making the stuff for me because I like doing it. And if people happen to enjoy consuming as well, that's
exactly
double whammy. It's
exactly
great.
Yeah, yeah.
But otherwise you can get caught in this loop where if you're only making things for someone else,